Nigeria's borders have been reopened after about 15 months of having them shut, and this comes as good news to quite a number of people. The borders were shut because of assumed petrol smuggling, which had some facts, food smuggling, and of course insecurity. But now that the borders have been reopened, food inflation in Nigeria is up 18.38% as of November from 17.3% in October. Overall inflation, of course, has been on the rise, and now currently at 14.8%, the highest in 34 months. But while the borders have now been reopened, the challenges of productivity remain the same. For instance, rice farmers only have to produce and sell for a certain high sum, perhaps 14,000 for a bag, or 15 or 20,000 when it was at the highest. They don't have to increase the volume of their land under cultivation, and more importantly, their yield per hectare. This is where the problem lies. There has been little or no effort to boost productivity in Nigeria. And what this means, now that the borders have been reopened, there would logically be influx of food items coming in from outside the country to compensate for the shortfall of the inadequate local production. In insecurity as well, the needed incentives that should have been put in place to get security operatives to be able to adequately defend the borders have not been put in place. The customs officers that should secure the nation's borders are perhaps not doing much of a good job, which is why we have a lot of smuggling and insecurity in the first place. Petrol smuggling, with a country that claims to have done away with subsidy in recent times, but the subsidy isn't quite entirely gone. And as long as Nigeria subsidizes petrol products, it will be attractive for people to smuggle them across the border. And of course, that problem is likely to remain as well. The question then is, what has Nigeria gained after 15, 16 months of closing its land borders, shutting down small businesses, making its neighbors unnecessarily hostile to business owners and Nigerians in general? The question, what has Nigeria gained?